We are a team of OBGYNs from the San Francisco Bay Area who teach two simulation-based curriculums to healthcare providers in Central America.
We call our program GOMOMS, which stands for Global Outreach Mobile Obstetric Medical Simulation. We use simulation as a teaching technique to teach postpartum hemorrhage, shoulder dystocia, as well as information about hypertension in pregnancy.
Our second curriculum is called GOGYNES, which stands for Global Outreach Gynecologic Surgery. We teach vaginal hysterectomy as well as pessary fitting.
Our goal and part of what makes us unique is that we've chosen to address the gap that exists among healthcare providers at a much higher level, at the hospital level. A lot of emphasis has been placed on the birth attendants in low resource areas, which is of great value. But we found that people at the higher levels were missing some of the latest techniques that we have in the United States. So our goal is to get to the residents and the physicians at those referral hospitals where those birth attendants will be sending people in and make sure that they're equipped with the latest information that often doesn't get to them because of language barriers. And I think we found simulation to be useful because
we found that using a simulation-based training model is very helpful in low-resource communities because of the varying levels of education in these communities and literally the lack of resources and access to more formal simulation models, that we've given them some tools that they can learn to make their own simulation models, and then we teach them based on the models, they can teach themselves and teach others.
It's the train-the-trainer teaching model that we're using, and this strategy can have the highest impact in low-resource settings.
In one of our Go Moms simulations, we use a birthing simulator to simulate a postpartum hemorrhage. Our trainees take on the roles of gynecologists, anesthesiologists, and nurses, and they have to work together to respond to the patient's vital signs and to save the patient using some of the techniques we've practiced beforehand. In this simulation, trainees use uterine massage, misoprostol, and a balloon tamponade made from a condom and a Foley catheter to stop the hemorrhage. The simulation environment allows healthcare providers to practice responding to critical situations under pressure, as a team, and while communicating effectively. We follow each simulation with a debrief in which trainees discuss what went well and how they can improve so that they are best prepared for real-life emergency situations.
No, vamos a ponerle un balón. Balón, prepárame un balón. El misoprostol ya se lo
sabe. Okay, ¿alguien, otra persona me ayuda a inflarlo?
Esto lo estás haciendo en la hora y parto, en quirófano.
Ah, estoy en quirófano. Sí, estamos en quirófano, para mí ya la preparan, la doctora se va a lavar.
Okay, entonces podemos hablar de este simulación.
Bien. La paciente ya se puede ir de
¡está viva!
Ay, salvamos una vida, gracias.
El tiempo para mí es lo más preciado en estos casos. Y si lo perdemos porque no estamos bien coordinados, el paciente va a pagar las consecuencias de esa poca coordinación. Si lo hiciéramos de esta manera periódicamente, creo que a la hora que lo tuviéramos ocurrirían menos detalles que nos vamos a olvidar porque nuestro cuerpo está como más ágil para responder a ese estímulo. Entonces creo que la mayor dificultad es que a veces solo lo vemos en una clase. Lo leemos, pero no simulamos esa situación. Cuando ya estamos en ella, hay muchos fracasos, hay detalles porque no hemos estado. Si no está un MB que ya estuvo en esa situación y nos auxilia, nos colapsamos ahí. Perdemos la noción de lo que vamos a hacer, nos desorientamos, pero creo que la forma de aprendizaje sí sería mejor así.
Cuando tú has adquirido esa experiencia, como dicen, haz las cosas bien desde el inicio y la vas a hacer siempre. Luego ya lo haces mecánico, sin pensar, pero porque aprendiste a hacerlo. Pero cuando algo se nos quedó, nos damos cuenta que en el quehacer de hacer las cosas ya por arco reflejo y mecánica, se nos van quedando esos vacíos, que no los tenemos bien metidos en nuestro consciente, y entonces allí nos sirve para reforzar.